Let us now discuss the interference by an air wedge. In previous section, we have studied about the interference in reflected light by wedge shaped film. Here, say if we consider a glass plate over which another glass plate is placed, but at some angle. And say here we place an object which is separating the two glass plates at some angle theta. And in this situation, this is an air wedge, which is developed due to the angular separation between the two glass plates. Here, if say a light beam is normally incident onto a glass plate, then from the two light waves which are reflected, the one from the top surface of air wedge and other from the bottom surface of air wedge, 1 and 2, will interfere in the reflected beam. And here, if we just have a look on the two waves, here we can see the wave 1 which is reflected from the bottom surface of the upper glass plate or the top surface of air wedge will not have any path added due to the reflection from a rarer medium. But if we talk about the light beam which is transmitted and reflected from the bottom surface of air wedge or the top surface of the lower glass plate will be reflected, and if here at point P the wedge thickness is T, the light will cover a path which is 2T extra compared to a wave 1. And in this situation here you can see this light beam 2 is reflected from a denser media. So in this situation, this will also have a lambda by 2 additional path. So in this situation, the light wave 2 is having an additional path of 2T plus lambda by 2. And in this situation, if this air wedge is replaced by another medium having refractive index mu, but if it is rarer than glass, then this path difference will be replaced by 2 mu t plus lambda by 2, because the equivalent path of this distance 2t in air will be finally taken as 2 mu t plus lambda by 2, is because it is reflected from a denser medium. Now in this situation here we can say the reflected light at P is bright, or there is a bright fringe at point P if the path difference, which is 2 mu t plus lambda by 2, in case of air wedge we can take it 2t plus lambda by 2, this must be equals to n lambda. And in this situation we are getting the value of T, that is the thickness of air wedge or the material wedge or the medium wedge which is filled between the two glass plates, can be written as 2n minus 1 lambda by 4 mu. And here if x is the distance of this point P from the wedge edge O, then here T can be written as x theta, like we have studied in the previous section. The value of x we are getting here is 2n minus 1 lambda by 4 mu theta. And in this situation we can take n is equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. And here we can write this x is the distance of nth bright fringe from point O. And this is unlike to the previous case when we were talking about a medium wedge which is denser than air. But here, due to these glass plates, you can see in this situation the reflected light will be in opposite phase when this T is negligible. So in this situation here we can see n we can take as 1, because at n equals to 0 there is no bright fringe obtained here. And similar to this, for no reflection at point P, we can write 2 mu t plus lambda by 2, the path difference will be 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, this is an odd multiple of lambda by 2. And here mu we can take as 1 if this is an air wedge. So in this situation, we are getting the value of t is equals to n lambda by 2 mu. Or if t is substituted as x theta, the value of x we are getting is n lambda by 2 mu theta, where we can take n as equals to, again in this situation, n equals to 0, we can talk about where the beams are having opposite phase or a path difference lambda by 2. So here n we can consider as 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So this will be again the distance of nth dark fringe from point O. So you must be careful about how the reflection takes place in case of an air wedge or any medium wedge which is trapped between two glass plates. And in reflected light, we can find out whether constructive and destructive interference is taking place at different distances from the edge of the wedge O.